whisper rambles, life updates, all that good stuff, and do it outside because it's so pretty outside. The snow everywhere, everything is white, the leaves and the rocks and everything. So I thought, let's do like a seasonal life update kind of thing. So I have my lo-fi mic and I'm just going to pee, letting you guys know what's been going on. So I am outside, so you are going to hear traffic noises. Luckily my block isn't too loud and what's the word I'm looking for? Like, the traffic just isn't heavy, especially during the day. But you can hear the hum of the highway that is just a few miles away. So you can kind of hear that hum. You will also be hearing some wind chimes that we have in our yard, which may actually be relaxing. Maybe. I'm hoping the wind isn't too bad. My tripod is shaking a little bit. It's pretty windy. But hopefully that sounds okay on the mic. I'm not gonna lie to you, it's cold. It's cold. But you know, I have my hat, my gloves. It's a feather on my glove. Whatever, that's gonna stay there. So yeah. Not life. That might be a plane. Sit there with my car completely off, and it was free. weren't like snow boots. They were just like booties. They were wet, so my feet were freezing. I was freezing. I was miserable. I was sad. So anyway, eventually the police got there and they talked to him first. And I'm just like awkwardly standing there, literally on the highway. We were on the highway. And then they came over to me and they were like, "Can you tell us what happened?" And I was like, "No." I was like, I don't know where he was. He was behind me. Oh, that was the thing. That was the funny thing. One of the cops, I could tell he was like a rookie. And the other cop was like older and he'd been doing it for a while. And the young cop was like, "So he was behind you?" And I was like, "Yeah." Like, how else would the front of his car be smashed and the back of mine be smashed? But whatever, he was just doing his job, so. I was like, yeah, I guess, yeah, he was behind me. So they collected our insurance cards, registration, license, all that. Took all the information into their car. Got back in our cars. It must have taken them a good 45 to 50 minutes to come back out of the car. They took forever. I don't know if that's how long it usually takes, but it took them forever. I was like, and I'm freezing, so I'm like, what the heck? So then the guy that hit me eventually comes over to me and I roll down my window and he goes, "I'm really worried about your back tire, like in the section of my car that he hit." He said, "I'm really worried about your tire. It's flat." Because originally I thought my car was going to be drivable. I thought I was just going to be able to drive it off of the scene. But sure enough, the tire had gone completely flat. So I knew I was going to need a tow truck or a tire or something. But it was so severely damaged in that area that I don't think a tire, like changing a tire, would have been practical for anybody. Surely not me. So, but he was nice. He was like, "You know what? I'm going to call my insurance. I'm going to make sure we get you a tire. I'm not driving away until I know you can drive away." But he did drive away. The police let him go because they said that they were going to get me a tow truck. So he eventually just drove away after we exchanged information and whatever. And, so the tow truck came eventually. That was another thing we had to wait for. Oh my god, it's so windy, guys. I'm so sorry. So eventually he came and he was like, "I'm gonna take you back to my shop. Like, we're gonna get you all fixed up and whatever." And I was like, like, I wanted it to be taken to the mechanic that my family goes to, that we know the owners and whatever. And like, I trust them and I know that they'll take care of me and they won't take advantage of me. So I had the cop ask the tow truck guy, like, "Can he take my car to the mechanic that I want?" And it wasn't far. It was like 10 minutes away from where the accident happened. And he was like, "Oh, like, it's a contracted highway. Like, I can't really," or whatever. "So your mechanic is gonna have to send a tow truck to get it from my shop." It was just like, I get it, there are rules and regulations, but it was just so annoying. So eventually my mechanic, again, I'm lucky enough to, like, my family knows them, so they somehow called the tow truck guy and convinced him to bring my car to their shop. I'm sure he wasn't happy about it, but so weird to not see my car there. It's just so weird. But again, like I said, could have been worse, right? So I'm not gonna, like, really complain. And unfortunately, these things happen. Accidents happen. That's why they're called accidents. You know, no one plans on them. I just hope that it doesn't take, like, forever to sort everything out and get the car fixed, because I know sometimes these things can be dragged out, so praying that doesn't happen. And yeah, so that was my big thing that happened last week, really only a couple days ago. I'm trying to think what else I can talk to you guys about. I have a true crime collaboration coming, like, soon, like possibly the next video you see. So that's exciting. It is with another ASMR content creator that specializes in true crime videos. We've been talking about collabing for literally months, so it's finally happening. So you guys can look forward to that. And I'm excited to start, you know, making more videos next year. I can't believe that 2020 is over. I think probably one of the first few videos that you see in 2021 is going to be a reflection, like my personal reflection of 2020. How it went for me, my thoughts overall on how it impacted the world and our society. And I think that'll be interesting, and it'll be kind of like a whisper ramble, so you guys like those. So hopefully that'll be interesting. I also have another true crime video that I know I want to do, like, by myself, not with anyone else, not a collab, but it's a case that I've been, like, reading about and watching videos on. I've basically watched, like, the whole testimony already in court, because it's all on YouTube, and it's been so fascinating for me. Like, I really want to talk about it, so I'm going to do that in January at some point. Gotta do my Netflix video. I thought I was gonna do one in December, but only uploading twice a week. I just didn't have time for it. I had more videos planned, so that doesn't have to be around Christmas time, so I'll do that in January. And yeah, so I hope you guys are going to enjoy your holidays if you celebrate, and, you know, celebrating New Year's. I know it's weird this year. It's so weird. Different for everybody, and it does make me sad, but you know what, we'll make the best of it, right? And we'll still be able to have fun, and thank God for Zoom and FaceTime and all that good stuff, right? So anyway, my hand is completely numb, so I think I'm going to start to wrap this video up. I know it's shorter for my normal whisper rambles, but dealing with the elements out here. So anyway, I'm gonna start editing this so I can get it up tomorrow, but thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed something a little bit different. I've been having so much fun. Oh, something just flew in my eye. Ow. I've been having so much fun just, like, making different videos rather than just sitting in the same spot in my room all the time. Kind of trying to change it up this month, so I hope that you guys enjoyed that, and I will see you